Hello and welcome to Flashback Generations.
Hello.
Today we have, in the 41st millennium, there's only war, of course. They're all friends in this game, because you've got like orcs fighting alongside tyranids and chaos and... but whatever. Before playing, each player is going to choose a side. Either the lonely space marines or the very mixed up chaotic races of orcs, chaos, necrons and tyranids. Every marine has movement points. A heavy marine has 4 and a light guy has 6. They move along the squares. Line of sight is anywhere on the board. There's a gene stealer over there. You can actually just target him and roll the dice according to your card. In this case, a heavy guy has 2 red dice. You just roll the red dice. He rolled a 1. What we're trying to do is beat his armor value, which is probably 3 or something. That probably might kill a Gretchen, who knows. Every mission has an objective, in this case, the one that we're going to play through. We have to go from point here to point over here. We're trying to escape. Along the way, obviously, we can expect several big bad guys, you know, all in the form of blip tokens. This game is ideally meant to be played as a kid's campaign.
Warning, gene stealers have infested parts of this sector. The main assault has been successful. The Space Marines have established a defensive perimeter while they prepare their attack on the heart of the Dreadnought faction. A preliminary attack is to be launched to reach the main access tunnel.
The basic premise of this mission is these Blood Angels have to traverse out these corridors over here. To get through these bulkheads, which are toughness 5, which means that I need a 4, which means I need a 5 or more to shoot them.
Smash through, yeah.
Yeah, get them out of the way.
That's the whole mission, just escape.
Yeah, so, I've got my lovely equipment that Pete has no idea what I have.
There's not that many choices.
we are using all the advanced stuff, so we got like bigger dreadnoughts and I've got like a tarantula and that sort of stuff. So, let's go.
Door is open.
The bolter guy stands forwards.
Right, so at that point, Sai stops and sweeps the area so I can place down my tokens, as many blip tokens as I wish, down there, to secretly.
These are all secret.
I like to surprise both Sai and myself.
When it comes to tactics, I don't think...
They're not needed in this game, to be honest. Well, you can do them if you want, but...
They're overrated.
We'll have another one there, I think. Is that a fair scattering? Yes, might try one more as well. Just about there. So,
yeah,
we put down about, I don't know, 12-ish blip tokens there, so Sai can't see them, but he can now carry on moving.
Let's open this door. Doors are removed when you open them.
These normal doors, yeah.
Do it for free. 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. 2. Yeah, 2.
Reveal these blips.
3, 4, 5, and...
open that door. So you reveal that blip. And not that blip because it's centre to centre line of sight. So
yep,
we've got an android here. A very nasty android. We've got Gretchen. Passes the Gretchen side. One there.
One Gretchen. Is it two Gretchen?
Another Gretchen, yeah.
There you go. Two Gretchens. All right. He's going to go back and have a pop at that Gretchen.
Okay.
So I roll 2 whites, needing a 1.
That's enough, yeah. So Sai gets his wages, which is a Gretchen token.
I get a victory point.
Yep.
Right, next up, this is easy, this game so far.
Yeah.
I'm going to easily win this. So I'm going to use a conversion beam gun.
Besides, I don't think you figured out how it works yet.
2. 3.
Oh. Yeah, yep. Carry on. You can see him. So we stop, reveal this blip. It's another Gretchen. Shock horror.
4. Right, let's shoot that big guy.
So the conversion beam is?
I shoot my big cannon that's going to have a blast.
It basically bounces off a wall.
So we get rid of these white dice. Let's roll. So I need a 3 or more. Oh, look at this.
Got a 4. The android's armor is 2, so he's blown up. Yeah.
Melted.
Done.
And that Gretchen? He's melted too, isn't he?
Right, so that was what? You got a 4 there, yeah?
Yeah.
No, because what happens is you got 4 there, it's 3 all round, and then it goes back down the line.
Oh, I see.
3,
okay.
2, 1. So you didn't blow yourself up this time.
I'm not.
A weird gun, that one, but very. It's quite fun to use that one.
Right, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's shoot the heavy Gatling gun.
No.
No, missed. The rocket launcher.
Yeah.
Now this rocket launcher, I'll point out, I get a reroll because I have a targeting system on it. Whee! 3.
3 blows the Gretchen away.
I'll blow up him actually.
Okay. So you've killed all but one visible aliens.
Yeah, and let's go with the plasma cannon. And he's gonna have a go.
You can combine shots with the last cannon. One red dice per shot.
Only one. One target.
Right, that's enough to kill most baddies.
Yeah. And the commander. 4, 5, and...
You only need one more square to see that go.
6.
6, yeah.
What is this?
It is.
Oh, Chaos Space Marine.
Chaos Space Marine.
Good.
Yeah.
Let's shoot him.
Two red.
I think it's just 2 red again, isn't it?
Yeah, you got the heavy bolter.
Heavy bolter.
That's no good.
No, I missed. So now we'll go with the tarantula. I get to put it into there.
Yeah, it's a weird one. It's right. 3 squares long, this thing.
It's a weird movement mechanism.
Move on fire.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's your first turn over. A few Gretchens killed. So, alien turn. So if there are other marine players, you can then, you go around the table clockwise, but I'm the next guy. So the first thing I do is draw an alien event card. We'll see what it is. New orders. Play this card on one of the marine players. He may then pick one extra order card. Oh. So that's bad for me.
Cool. Great. Yep.
Okay. So I picked his card.
I did.
So I can move my blips. They can move up to 6. I can move the aliens depending on the stats.
Am I dead now?
He might be. So the marine, the Chaos Marine's got 2 white, whatever he does. And you've got an armor value 2, so the marine doesn't want to die.
He's got armor value 3 because he's got a force field.
Right.
He's got a force field.
In which case, I'll hand-to-hand combat him. So I roll 2 white, so does the commander.
And so do I.
I got 0, so I got 0, so nothing happens.
Yeah.
Okay. Then he can move. He's got a move of probably 6, yeah. He's going to go 1, 2, open that door. That will reveal this guy.
Oh, 3. You dirty.
Hi.
There's another Chaos Space.
His twin brother is there, yeah. His twin brother. Over here, thank you.
You get him, yeah.
And then this Chaos Marine will...
Close combat?
Yeah, why not? 1, 2, 3. You can't close combat diagonally, so I'll go 4. And then close combat the hell out of you. I got 4.
1.
It's silently got a 1.
Take 3
then,
lives.
So. Yep, 3 lives.
Right, he's half dead.
That was the right move. This blip will go 1, revealing itself, and it's a Gretchen. Oh, that's disappointing. 2,
close combat
3,
as well.
4, 5, 6. Yeah, let's close combat, yeah.
This game actually just seems
Gretchen gets 1 white in hand-to-hand. He's rubbish. He got 0, so I got 1.
1!
The Gretchen died.
Take it, Gretchen.
Yeah, there's your wages.
Yep.
And then we've got some blips, so let's move this blip here, open the door, revealing itself to be a Gretchen.
1 Gretchen. Is he going to close combat me?
No, he's going to shoot you.
Okay.
He's got 2 white. He's going to shoot the last cannon in the distance, actually.
Sure.
Right. And he nearly did it. Got 2 there, nearly.
2, yeah.
And then he can't move. He's not moved. Yeah, he has moved. So this guy's going to go here. Reveal himself to be a Gretchen. Yeah. Why did Psy up here by moving the Gretchen mysteriously? He's going to shoot the last cannon in the distance. Nope. Fail. And then this guy...
Those white dice, now and then they can actually get a kill.
Oh yeah, they can. It's always worth it. They'll open that door. I don't think I'm visible. I'm not visible there. So there's something moving through the corridors. Right, so that's my turn done. At this point, I could bring on reinforcements if I wanted to.
Yeah.
I might actually do that because I've just got to check the map. So the reinforcements actually come on here.
What, behind me?
Yeah, well, we've slightly... one of these boards is the wrong way around. Don't worry about it.
Oh, right.
What I'll use is I'll use...
The other board?
Yeah, no, I'll use...
that board.
This board here. So what I'll bring on is... basically, these are light blip tokens, but I just put them into play. Let's have the Chaos Squad. So I'm bringing on the Chaos Space Marine, with a heavy rocket launcher, and the Chaos Space Marine Commander.
That guy.
I'm jealous. I want my own Marine Squad. Yeah, those
three. Those three.
Yeah, they come on here-ish.
Wow.
And they're just revealed. They just march on. So a bit of help needed. The Gretchen is struggling.
Hmm.
They don't. That's at the end of my turn. So now, yeah, it's over to Psy.
No. I feel like you've got loads of guys on there. Can I see them from here?
Center line of sight. So yeah, yes, you can. The commander can see a couple of them.
With the
Gretchen's block, yeah, the blue block. So. I mean, I don't get to hide them. I've got to reveal what I'm putting on with reinforcements.
All right, that's... I'll shoot with the minigun first.
Yeah.
Let's get rid of some of these Gretchen.
Okay. That's two Gretchen's worth. Yep.
Can he see them? the oddity.
I would say that I you could see the back two.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do that then. So he's got three shots, two red dice per shot.
Yeah, and you've got to nominate... Well, we presume you've got to nominate whether you're going to combine the shots with the last cannon.
So I'm going to do three dice and three dice.
Right, two shots of three each.
Yeah.
I don't know if you can do that because they're two shots, two dice a shot. So you could do four and two, or two, two, two.
But you have a rocket launcher and a commander.
Yeah. Oh, you can't split an individual shot, so it's two and four,
right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Units of two.
So what's this explosion mean?
That means it's a four square area, so...
Oh, I can kill two.
But you can't affect squares that you can't see. So you could hit them both.
So can I hit those two?
No, because you can't see the nearest one.
All right, let's hit these
those
two then.
Two, yeah.
With four dice and then a...
Four and a two, yeah. Okay, four. So first shot.
Jettered!
Wipes them out. Ouch.
See them later. And that's it?
Yep.
I can't see the other guy, can I? No.
No, so that was a bit of a fail by me. But that's where they have to come on when you reinforce, so...
And let's have the commander go.
Yep.
Because he can't move, because he's a tarantula.
Yeah, because he's shot, yeah.
Yeah. Three, four, five, six. The commander looks at you sweetly.
And misses?
Yes, he does.
Right.
Right, let's have more people then. God, all these choices.
Did you fire the assault cannon already? I forgot.
The assault cannon's gone. Yeah. I'll turn him around to say that he's gone. That guy's gone. One, two, three, four. Last cannon. Let's have a shot at the further guy.
The first, the wall in the way there.
Oh.
You can shoot the nearer guy.
Nearer guy?
Oh, in fact, you've just revealed this. Which is a dreadnought.
Oh, is that the big one?
Yeah. Well, it's the tall one, but it's only got two weapons. So I need a two-weapon head. Classic, what shall I go with? I think I'll go with this last cannon. I like the look of it. Yeah, so we'll,
all right,
we'll stick
a
this guy right. on the big legs. Big
How
legs.
Many, what's his defense?
His armor is four, and he's got three life points, basically. So the first time you kill him, you'll shoot a weapon off.
Right.
You know, it's like that.
Well, I think it would be stupid if I didn't shoot at him.
Okay.
Am I right?
Yep. So he's just appeared. Oh, this miniature's a bit rickety.
Right, so what you're saying is I need to roll a 5. With all 3 dice, yeah?
Yes. His armor value is 4, so you need to get a 5 to...
Let's roll a 5.
1.
That wouldn't do it. Alright. Four. Let's have a pop with the rocket launcher.
Yeah, which square are you shooting?
That one.
Right.
I get a reroll with the rocket launcher.
Oh! 5. I think his las cannon's gonna fall off, I think.
No las cannon. This is amazing. This is amazing. Right, the conversion beam comes in.
That is a terrible place for the dreadnought to be stood in front of the conversion beam. Is it 3 dice?
Three dice. Yes. Yeah. He's tuning that square, so it'll actually impact him.
You've got to go in a straight line, so you'll need to be either there or there. Did you have the movement?
I didn't have the movement.
Right.
No, I didn't have
that. All right, conversion beams are deadly but awkward.
Yeah, I thought the guy just in front of him.
Okay. So you got 3, so that kills the marine, and then it goes 3, 2, 1, it bounces back at you, but it's all right.
Well, you know, it was a hot shot, but you know.
Yeah. I'm getting trounced here.
And then this guy, 2, 3, 4. Yep, he just goes in there. Let's have a shot at that guy. No, nope, he did nothing to him.
All right.
So, that's it. Done.
Okay.
Then we're going to chuck my blind grenades. Play this card at the end of your turn. The alien player may not attack any of your miniatures on his next turn.
Right.
Done.
Alien turn. Here comes the card. My favourite. Gene Stealer.
Stupidest card in the entire game.
And in this mission, this is the first one of the expansion. When you draw that card, you get 3 Gene Stealers. But of course, the sides play the blind grenade, so they're not going to be able to attack.
So, oh my god, such a stupid card.
Where do I put them? Next to any marine or commander miniature. So that's interesting. I've been in this situation before in this game, so don't worry, there's a plan. So I'll put him next to the commander. I'll put him next to this guy. No, I won't. I'll put him next to this guy. And I'll put this gene sealer, drops out of the ceiling, and cause terrible distress to the tarantula gunner, I think. It won't, because he can't attack. But, so with my turn, I haven't got many guys on deck at the minute, so the Gene Stealers can't attack.
Nope.
So it is going to run away. It's going to run through there, so it's got 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Open the door. 8. This gene sealer will do something similar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
These things are absolutely bent.
This one's happy.
As expected.
It'll stay where it is. Now, the dreadnought, the marine will go next. He's going to rush in and do hand-to-hand combat with the...
No, he won't. Not with the...
No, I won't. No, you're right. I can't attack. Then. I forgot. So he's going to go 1... 2. The dreadnought will shuffle out of the way a bit.
Oh, interesting.
3. You can go that. That's far enough, I think. And then, what else have we got? That's it, I think. That's my lot. Oh, I've got the other marine there. He'll just zip over there. Just make sure he's out of sight. Reasonably out of sight.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that was a nullified alien turn, thanks to Sai's blind grenade. Luckily, he only gets to use it once. Yeah, over to Sai.
Over to me. Okay. So, as soon as I walk in that door, Pete gets to go blip mad.
I get to do a sweep. You do a sweep of the place, yeah.
Yeah, so it's not really in... Oh god, this game is just really tense. I'm gonna put him there. Can I shoot the gene sealer?
Can you see center to center? Yeah.
Well, it's the way it explodes, then I'm thinking.
Yeah. Well, it wouldn't matter because he's on his own.
Let's go.
It?
2 reds.
Nope. He dodged it.
3 won't even do it. No.
They're tough, those gene stealers.
Yeah. So this guy moves 6.
Yeah, he does, surprisingly.
6. Okay, there we go.
Tarantula.
We'll put him there. Let's shoot with this guy.
Assault cannon, yes.
Assault cannon at that gene stealer.
2, not enough. Gene stealers are armor 3.
And then he can walk to there. Conversion cannon.
Do a diagonal, yeah. That's 3 dice? Yeah, it's one of the yeah. expansion weapons.
Killed!
Nope.
No.
1.
1?
No good.
That's useless. Last gun. This game is just like...
Yeah, that's done it. That's got a gene stealer, yeah.
Oh, that card. That card. So what is he doing close combat?
Close combat, the Dreadnoughts. I'll have to look it up. The original Dreadnought does 2 red and 2 white in hand-to-hand combat. I think these ones might be worse, I'm not sure. I'll have to look it up. But yeah, the at least 2 red and 2 white.
Alright, this guy is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4... Five, six, and he's gonna fight you in close combat with a melter bomb.
Okay.
I get an extra red card, an extra 2 red dice. So I got 2 red and 2 white. So in close combat, you're comparing numbers, and it's plus and minus, and each number different is a wound. So I got 3.
5.
5. You're not gonna roll.
I got the same. I think the default is for a dreadnought is the same. So. 5. Who's this against?
That's him.
Oh, right. Okay. Unfortunately. He's had it. I thought you were fighting the dreadnought.
Ah, I'm just, well, if I'd known I was going to roll a 5, I would have.
Lucky me.
And I got Commander, who will go there and have a pop at the gene sealer.
Yeah.
Because I'm too afraid to stand in there.
Nope.
Oh, nothing.
Now you'll pay. All right.
Yeah, I'm all done. Yes.
All done. Right, alien turn then. Report in. Play on... I'll put it here so you can have a look. Play on one of the marine players. That player may not move or attack with his commander miniature on his next turn as he must report in.
That is such a stupid card.
Stupid card fluff-wise, yeah. What? It's like, no, I'm not fighting. Yeah. I've got to...
Hang on, guys. Pause. Stop fighting.
Oh, God. Right, so then on we go. So now I can attack again. So...
Yes, you can.
Let's try and kill the commander. So, let's go with a dreadnought for laughs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Dreadnoughts can't stop under a doorway.
Oh,
but he's got long legs. Now, he has got his missile launcher. So I'm going to put it on the tarantula. Hang on, they get more... Am I in your arc of fire there?
There's an arc of fire. No, it's from the front of my gun. It's out of there.
Is it? Right, okay.
So my defence is...
All right, so we'll try and throw lob a bomb in there. So it's the same as the old... was it 2 red?
Who are you shooting at?
The tarantula guy himself.
Right.
Yeah, diagonally from there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay.
That's how it works. So he gets the full blast of 2. So it does nothing.
Armour.
Power
armour saves, sir.
I think Dreadnought...
You've got two white as well.
So I'll shoot him at the 2 white.
Same guy.
Worth a try. Nope, nothing. Right. Okay. The Dreadnought's being very rubbish. This gene steer on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll chew on the commander.
Comes back for the commander.
I'm on 2 red with the gene stealer. I scored a 3.
Oh, come on.
It's only one life. Only one life there.
Yeah, it could have died, so I'll take that.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I can't quite make it with the other one. But I can go get this guy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Pick up the gun.
Yeah. Got 2.
Come on, guy.
That's 1 dead marine.
There he is. This, I'm surprised it hasn't happened more fluidly so far.
Yeah, we've lost a gene stealer. So, this marine, he's going to go... He might as well pile in and have a go at the old commander. 2, 3. I must go there because I'm not allowed to attack diagonally. So yeah, it's just two eye versus two eye, I think.
Two eye versus two eyes. What did you guess?
One.
One, and I rolled a zero.
Zero, another life off.
Down to my last. He's obviously making this phone call. He's like, hang on.
Been punched in the face while he's doing? Radioing in. That's all I've got because you refused to set foot in the next board. So I can't bring anybody else. Well, I could do reinforcements. Actually, let me do that. Yeah. Reinforcements. Let's chuck down two vanilla marines and we'll put them tucked in there again, please.
Yeah.
All right.
Two marines.
Risky, but, you know, what the hell.
All right. Let's go with me then. Conversion cannon.
Who are you shooting?
The big guy.
It will go. It'll go through him and it won't stop till it hits the wall and then it'll do the bounce back. There's a chance you could... no, you won't kill the gene stealer. So the way it works is it goes and then it hits the wall and then bounces back. Conversion.
Does it not hurt him?
It'll go straight through him. It doesn't do anything until it hits a wall and then it starts to bounce.
Oh, okay.
It's one, like a big two, tennis three. Ball go.
I'll hit there instead then.
Yeah, so that'll go there.
Yeah, let's do it.
Right, you got three. So that'll be a three there and a two there. So it's not enough to do anything this time.
Last cannon. Yep. Three on him.
One, nothing.
God, this game is just such a, like... just keep on rolling dice.
The Marines are more sort of stormtroopers than Space Marines, really.
They feel like it. Yep. That guy's just phoning his friend. Three and...
Wasn't that last turn?
Four. He's going to shoot that guy.
Okay. Well, you can share it out with the assault team. Nothing. Harsh dice.
Big gun. So I got six in total. Yeah, sorry, Commander. If you're just sitting there making phone calls.
Then you're going to blast your own Commander. Yeah. You could choose the four squares that he's not in. Wouldn't you?
Yeah, but I want to hit the gene sealer.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah, so, sorry, Commander.
Six dice to everybody in that four.
Six dice.
Right, that kills everybody, including Sai's own Commander, which is funny.
It was worth it.
It was useless.
That was stupid. All right, this rocket launcher is going to go there and shoot those two.
Yeah.
Come on, rocket launcher. Come on.
No.
I get a reroll. Come on.
No.
You're useless.
Right.
I'm done.
Done right. Alien turn. What's going to happen?
I felt like I did my absolute best there.
What's going to happen? Mech assault. All the androids get another go. Oh, and the dreadnought may move to twice their normal move this turn, as well as attack. So that's handy for the dreadnought. So, yes.
You can move 12 and attack.
Yeah.
All right. I don't think you need it.
One, two, three, four, five. Six. Let's sit right there and attack the las cannon dude. Hand to hand combat.
Alright, okay.
That's a question. No, hand to hand combat.
Yeah, sure.
Three. That wasn't stellar. Hey, he's dead.
Right. Another one down.
We've got a gene stealer. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Let's chew on the conversion beamer.
He's a
threat. Hand-to-hand combat.
Yeah.
Two red. I've scored a mighty zero. I'm going to lose the gene stealer.
Come on.
Oh, he smashed it.
Get in.
Smashed it.
Get in.
That's not supposed to happen.
This game is brilliant.
Right, we've got a vanilla marine. He's going to run in here and start wailing on that marine missile launcher dude.
Close combat.
And
just
falls over.
Close combat's just an easy way to almost guarantee you could kill something.
This guy will come in here and do the same thing.
Yeah.
Try. Oh, rubbish.
Come on.
Nope.
Oh,
all zeros. These
dice.
Well, aren't we?
Yeah.
They are pretty harsh dice, to be fair.
Are you done?
I'm out.
Oh. I killed all those gene sealers.
Oh my god. Yeah. For now.
Right.
Not enough Gretchens, that's the trouble. Here
it comes. Fire order is on.
Shoot twice.
Yeah, everyone can shoot, move, shoot.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Two shoots.
Two shoots, yes. So, let's do it. You're taking six dice and six dice. I want to see one of them die.
We need an FAQ. The tarantula, if he can shoot twice now, but if he shoots, he can't move. That's why. Whoa! Four.
Hang on, six dice. Yes.
What's that? A lot. Six. Who's that on? The Dreadnought?
Well, that's the only one target.
Yeah, Dreadnought. Armour value... He's dead.
I would have thought. Four?
Yeah.
Do I not just lose one?
No, you did... No, you did.
Four. Oh, because you lost more... Because he's got three... Does he have a life?
Yeah, he's got gun, and his body. So
he's got three lives.
Yeah, pretty much.
Ah, okay. So I went six, so 5-6 would have gone over.
Yeah.
Gun, body.
Yeah.
All right, and next shot, come on.
30 points he's worth.
Let's hit the
other guy. I thought you did six dice, did they?
Yeah, I did. I got two shots. I did my shooting order.
Fire twice, yeah. Whoa, five. That gets rid of somebody. And I presume you picked the four squares that didn't kill your own man.
Yes. Okay. And then I'll just move.
Can't move and fire with the tarantula. The card just lets you shoot twice, but I'll let him off.
We're not sure. GW, an FAQ for this game, please.
Yeah, it's long overdue.
Yeah, I'll just move him there.
All right.
Two, three. Come on, conversion.
This is funny. Go for it.
You're
setting off a conversion beam in a small...
In fact, I'll shoot the rock a little.
Yes.
Two, three. Yeah, the conversion cannon, I could see you.
You're doing well better than our
I could see you laughing. Right, come on. I'm all pumped up now.
Yeah.
I'm ready to make it. Right, do you have reinforcements coming on, or do you want to do it?
Well, it's my turn, so first I've got to do is an alien event. Auto defense. You may shoot at any one Marine or Commander miniature on a room square, roll one heavy weapons die. So I'm going to shoot the conversion beamer. He's on a room square there.
He is.
I need a three here. And I get it. Oh, he's just died. Thanks for it.
This game is just relentless.
Yeah. That's a freebie. Now I can move my miniatures.
Okay, so I think the camera cut out at the very end. So what we'll need to do is, I'll just briefly say what happened. So I used a movement order, which made me double my moves. So what happened is, this rocket guy just ran in and just like, I need to get in there quick. That Gretchen was probably back there. He ran in here. He just took a shot at the door. He did his best, nearly got it. Didn't quite, you know. So then this other guy, he ran in as well. By the way, Pete at this stage had put blips everywhere and, you know, it was just like, okay, you know, quick, now or never. This dreadnought appeared and, you know, of course.
Yeah, the dreadnought did nothing.
Taking another shot at the door. Dreadnought. Unleashed hell. And that guy, no, he literally hang on there. He is fine. Then Pete drew.
Gene Stealers again.
Gene Stealers. And oh, my face, I think I just sank. It's like, oh my God. So anyway, what happened is this Gene Stealer, killed him. Dead. Next one. Right. Dead. Right. Okay. So that's my Gene Stealer noises. Over here. you think this is going to happen, but that guy actually beat off the beat him off. So this guy had just taken the Gene Stealer out, survived all the fire from this guy with the four cannons.
Yeah,
you know, and this guy's just like, yeah, I'm hard, I'm well tough. All these Gretchens just ran in, tried to get him. This guy, nailed one, nailed two, third one, got him. So this guy, man of the match for Pete.
Death by Gretchen.
That's him. All right.
Better than a dreadnought, guaranteed.
Yeah, there you go. We'll go on to the conclusion there. Space Crusade.
Great game.
That's a game I actually think I love putting it on the table, but I hate playing it.
Yeah, well, it is tense for the Marine player, especially if you're on your own, definitely.
It's sort of...
It's just, it feels like you're endlessly rolling zeros, doesn't it? You
know, yeah, I mean, just judging from that video there, from what we're doing, it seems like you're just constantly rolling dice.
Yeah, like for a one or a two, you know.
The thing I don't like about this game is, I think tactically, it doesn't really have tactics.
No.
Like, there's sort of absent tactic. You know, this, just move, roll dice, move, roll dice. It's very, very, it's very fast.
Yeah.
Like, you can tell that they thought they'd make interesting with this deck, but it seems like one way or the other, it's way too strong or way too weak, or
it does
very random stuff without actually making the game interesting. And the same with my orders, you know, like double shots and double moves. I mean, yeah, it sounds interesting, but it's kind of not. It's just...
Yeah.
It's very dull.
Well, the key point is it's very exciting when you're about 11.
Yeah, I know. Well, we are...
not 11.
We are kind of having to go for a game from 1990, so...
Yeah.
You know, there's only so much...
No, I used to play this as a kid and we absolutely loved it because we weren't up to tactics and nuances. You know, we just charged the miniatures each other and rolled the dice. And somebody would win and somebody would lose. I think it does work. It seems to be designed, you know, looking back now with what we know about games now, you need to have three Marine squads in play.
Yes.
You know, because then the alien player is basically surrounded and pressured. The alien player doesn't get any extra troops for more Marine players. That's why it's completely imbalanced if there's just one Marine squad.
But
it's ridiculously imbalanced, you know.
And then you can look at it another way. The game kind of sort of suggests it wants you to play the campaign the whole way through.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think a lot of games, I'm not saying this game kind of falls foul to it not being that great a campaign system.
It's simple, yeah. So if you basically, you've got like an XP system and you get honor badges, and the Chaos player, or the alien player, gets chaos marks, and basically as you build these up, you go up in rank and you can have more event cards, and the alien player can start with a few of these alien event cards in a hand that you can play whenever you like. So that's great when you draw Gene Stealer, you know.
Yeah.
Keep that and pop it when you want to pop it. But I mean, I think for kids it's a great game. It's a really good game still for kids if you're not too bothered about it, you know, the finer nuances. But you need at least three kids playing it, you know, two Marines and one alien. That works well.
In your opinion, is this better than HeroQuest?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
HeroQuest is the best game ever made, and anyone who says otherwise is wrong.
I know, controversial. It is. Because
heresy, right there.
I know, it is heresy, yeah. And I am not a 40k player or anything, but this is just, you get more fun out of it. The trouble is, I never played HeroQuest as a kid, so I imagine HeroQuest was also awesome as a kid. It annoys me now, HeroQuest. I think it's just,
it's funny.
This is the Switch situation.
It's funny, isn't it? Like, HeroQuest and Space Crusade, both these generic fantasy and sci-fi games. This game has, you know, the orcs, the Tyranids, the Chaos, and...
Android Necrons.
Yeah, Necrons as well. It has everything in the one team. And you know, HeroQuest did the same thing.
Bloodthirster working alongside goblins.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting that these games kind of said, let's put all these hero tropes, but eventually they make great big worlds out of it, you know? So it's kind of amazing how they've done so well out of it.
Well, it's a big box of, you know, army samplers, isn't it? You know. Possibly before they knew they were doing that, but it was like, look, it's some orcs, it's some androids. Want to know more? You know, go look at this website or go to this shop, etc. Not in those days.
I totally recommend you don't play this game. It's just...
If you've got, like, kids, if you've got kids, yeah, it's worth a go. Some kids will get wound up by it, especially if they play Marines and they get pressure.
Yeah, just rolling those dice. Close combat.
The dice are a bit depressing. You know, there's mostly zeros on those.
It's just...
When you get the big result, it means something. You know, it's like,
a big shot. When I took down that Dreadnought, I was ecstatic.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. So, but no, it's not... it's a curio, you know, it's a nostalgic curio for adults, but I think it's still got some legs for kids, definitely.
Okay. All right, well, we'll leave it there. Cheers for watching, guys.
See ya.
See you later.